to the Mount Olive AME Zion Church, where we are advancing the kingdom of God by making disciples. Thank you for joining us. We pray that you will be encouraged by the word that is shared on today. At the end of the message, we will provide you more information on how to connect with our church. Be blessed.
The announcements.
Mount Olive's Holy Communion service at 12 noon via Zoom. Saturday, November 13th, 1 p.m., members meeting via Zoom. Saturday, November 13th, Making a Change prayer service hosted by Walters Memorial AME Zion Church, Reverend Elvin Clayton, Pastor. Saturday, December 11th, Hartford District Super Saturday and Third Missionary Mass Meeting, Buds Roundup, hosted by Cross Street AME Zion Church, Middletown, Connecticut, Reverend Moses Harvell, Pastor. Saturday, December 18th, Mount Olive Angel Tree Christmas Party, 10 a.m. to 1 p.m. Rain date, December 19th. If you would like to volunteer, please contact Sister Roz Brown. December 27th to the 30th, Annual Christian Education Winter Meeting, Chicago, Illinois. Truthville 2021, Life After Exile. Psalms 126, verse 1. Due to safety concerns, the meeting will be held virtually. More information forthcoming. News First, Fellowship and Prayer with the Pastor. Tuesday at 1 p.m. via conference call. Prayer every Wednesday at 11:30 a.m. Bible study every Wednesday at 12 noon and 6 p.m. via Zoom and conference call. Sunday school every Sunday at 9:30 a.m. via conference call. Class leaders meeting is every second and fourth Monday at 1 p.m. Please govern yourselves accordingly and have a blessed week.
Hello, beloved. Peace and blessings. Thank you for taking out the time to join with us. My name is Kelsey Hopson, and I am the pastor of this wonderful community of faith here in Waterbury, Connecticut, Mount Olive AME Zion Church. There is a word from the Lord for us on today. And so I trust, hope that you are as excited as I am about this word, that you might receive the blessing that God has for us on today. We're going to be taking a look at Ecclesiastes chapter 3, verse 1. Ecclesiastes chapter 3, verse 1. And then we're going to take a look at Genesis chapter 8, verse 22. Genesis chapter 8, verse 22. And I'm going to be reading from the New Revised Standard Version, the New Revised Standard Version. And scripture reads, "For everything there is a season and a time for every matter under heaven." For everything, there is a season and a time for every matter under heaven. Genesis chapter 8, verse 22, and it reads, "As long as the earth endures, seed time and harvest, cold and heat, summer and winter, day and night shall not cease." I'm going to read that one more time. Genesis chapter 8, verse 22. "As long as the earth endures, seed time and harvest, cold and heat, summer and winter, day and night shall not cease." Amen. God's word for the people of God. Praise be to God. Let's bow our heads in the word of prayer. Lord God, we thank you, Lord, for this preaching moment. Lord, we thank you for your word. We thank you, Lord, for your grace, Lord God, the ways that you bless us, and we don't even deserve it, Lord God, but every time we turn around, you continue to bless us, Lord God. We thank you, Lord, that you watched over us last night, that you woke us up this morning, oh God. We thank you, Lord. Now meet us where we are, Lord God, at the place of need, Lord God, for you indeed, you know all, Lord God. And so you know what it is that we truly stand in need of, Lord God. Lord, and so here we are now. We pray now, oh God, that the words of my mouth, that the meditations of our hearts will be acceptable in thy sight, oh Lord, our strength and redeemer. Lord God, we pray for the anointing that makes preaching possible, powerful, and practical, Lord God. We give you praise in advance for what you are about to do. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. 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 And so this new series is called Different Seasons, Same God. Different Seasons, Same God. And part one, I want to talk to you from the tag Maximize the Season. Maximize the season, maximize the season. Daylight saving time in most of the United States starts on the second Sunday in March and it ends on the first Sunday in November. And this is the first Sunday in November. And so 2 a.m. clocks were turned backward 1 hour to 1 a.m. local standard time. Sunrise and sunset were about an hour earlier on November the 7th than the day before. There was more light in the morning. Also, this is called fallback or winter time. And yesterday was the first evening that I really had need of a winter coat. I mean, the temperature, it seemed to have just changed all of the sudden, but really it wasn't that sudden, but it was the first time that I had need for a legitimate winter coat. In the Northern Hemisphere, the fall season will officially, is going to give way to the winter season, December the 21st. And so a season, what is it? It is a period of the year that's distinguished by special climate conditions. And we and the four seasons, summer, spring, fall, and winter, they follow one another regularly. And each has its own light, its own temperature, and weather patterns that generally repeat each year. But due to climate change and pollution, that is being impacted. But generally speaking, each has its own light, temperature, weather patterns that repeat. Seasons, though, they have an enormous influence on vegetation and plant growth. And winter typically it has a cold weather, little daylight, and limited plant growth. In the spring, plants, they sprout trees and leaves unfold and flowers, they blossom. The summer is the warmest time of the year and it has the most daylight. So plants grow quickly and autumn temperatures drop and trees lose their leaves. It's amazing because even now in November, there are trees that still have many of their leaves here in New England. Certain flowers like poinsettias, they only bloom during the winter. Seasonal changes in precipitation and temperature affect soil moisture, evaporation rates, and river flows, or lake levels, and snow coverage, and leaves fall and plants wither as cold and dry seasons approach. And these changes in vegetation, they affect the type and the amount of food available for humans and other organisms and animals. In temperatures and polar regions, they must find alternate food sources or move to warmer locations or even hibernate. And you know what? You and I, we may change our wardrobe with the seasons, grabbing a heavy winter coat or a heavy coat in the winter while wearing only light t-shirt in the summer. And although ecosystems, plants, and animals can't adjust their attire quite so easily, they have evolved to make changes to help them survive seasonal conditions caused by the rotation of the earth around the sun. And beloved, we need to know that our human existence, that it is full of seasons. Our human existence is full of seasons, and I would love to tell some of you that your life will at some point settle down into four distinct, simple seasons. But many of you, you realize that your life, it is full of not four seasons, but numerous seasons. And these seasons, like a coin, they tend to have a couple of sides. Seasons have both good and bad times, disappointments and satisfaction, successes and failures, joy and pain. You guessed it, sunshine and rain. And so these seasons, they affect you. They affect the ways in which you move and flow and live out your purpose, and the ways in which we're able to be productive. How we deal with these seasons, they affect our relationships. And your relationship, it may be impacted by the season that somebody else is in. It may be affected by the season that somebody else is in. And it's imperative that we're able to recognize these seasons. Ecclesiastes chapter 3, verse 1 says, "For everything there is a season and a time for every matter under heaven." The Amplified says there is a season, a time appointed for everything, and a time for every delight and event or purpose under heaven. The New Century version, it says everything on earth has its special seasons. And so, beloved, I want us to know that regardless of the season in life, that we can live purposeful and productive lives in every season. Now, what this looks like, it's going to vary. What this looks like, it may very well and understandably look and feel different in different seasons. But we're going to deal with the fact that although we have different seasons, it's the same God. Those of you who serve God, those of you who know God, understand that God is the same yesterday, today, and forevermore. And so although we may find ourselves in different seasons, and you keep on living, you will find yourself in different seasons, God remains the same. And so I want to talk to us about in this message how we can maximize the season. How do we maximize the season? And so there are a few things that we must come to grips with first in regards to seasons in order to maximize them and not miss what we can actually get out of the season. And so one of the things some folk, we think that maybe we can control things and maybe we're the cause of things. And sometimes that may be the case, but we need to understand in order to minimize our frustration and to maximize, the season, we need to understand that they're beyond our control. The seasons, they are beyond our control. One night, the second year of Nebuchadnezzar's reign, in Daniel, there is the record that that Nebuchadnezzar, he had a disturbing dream. In fact, he had several disturbing dreams, and he wanted to know the meaning of the dream. And so they sent for Daniel, and Daniel told his three friends to pray to God that God would tell them the secret, the meaning of the dream. And that night, the secret was actually revealed to Daniel in the vision. And Daniel, the text says that he praised God of heaven. And Daniel, he indicated, and he said this, he controls, talking about God, said he controls the world events. He removes kings and sets up other kings. He gives wisdom to the wise and knowledge to the scholar. Another translation says this, the Good News Bible says this, God controls the times and the seasons. He makes and unmakes kings. In other words, God is in control. Another way to put this in theological terms is that God is sovereign. God is sovereign. Seasons, y'all. We're able to minimize frustration and maximize the season when we come to grips with the fact that seasons are beyond our control. And so not only are they beyond our control, but seasons are oftentimes misunderstood. Misunderstood. Sometimes we misunderstand seasons because God knows all and our knowledge is limited. God has an internal perspective and we have a limited perspective that is limited by time. And in fact, even by our past and our present. Therefore, when we experience seasons, they can be very misunderstood. Ecclesiastes chapter 3, verse 11 says, God does everything just right and on time. Yeah. He's an on-time God. Yes, he is. But people, the text says, can never completely understand what he is doing. In other words, God can be a bit confusing because guess what? His ways are not our ways and his thoughts are not our thoughts. And so as the heaven is high above the earth, so are God's thoughts and God's ways. And so when we experience various seasons in life, we can't completely understand what God is doing in the seasons. One theologian said, life can only be understood backwards, but must be lived forwards. Hindsight is 20/20. We oftentimes understand things better when we look back. We're more likely to have greater perspective after something has happened or after we've gone through something, and then we're able to look back and we're able to see meaning. And so, beloved, you know, we experience different seasons, but it's the same God. And we're able to maximize the season, but there are some foundational things that, again, we need to understand. And so, yes, not only are the seasons, they're beyond our control and often misunderstood, but understand in regards to seasons that God indeed has a plan and purpose for each season. God has a plan and a purpose for each season. Yet listen, when we're trying to figure it out, God has already figured it out. You know the passage, you're familiar with the passage, Romans 8, verse 28. And we know that all things work for the good of those who love the Lord and are the called according to his purpose. Another translation says, we know that all that happens to us is working for our good if we love God and are fitting into his plan. And so we work with God as opposed to against God. God doesn't cause all things, but God is able to work in and through all things. God is able to use all things for our good and God's glory. The Amplified says, and we know with great confidence that God, who is deeply concerned about us, causes all things to work together. God doesn't cause all things, but God causes those things to work together as a plan for good for not everybody, but those who love God. Yeah, those who love God. To those who are called according to his plan and his purpose. And when we respond to the call of God's great salvation, amen, and then we sign up for God's plan for our lives. And rather than being constant rebellion and working against God, we work with God. And then when we deal with different seasons, God, who's the same yesterday, today, and forevermore, hallelujah, God has a plan in effect to use whatever is happening in that season for our good. God has a plan or purpose for each season, beloved. But listen, and this is where, you know, folk can get a bit perturbed and confused, and we think that because God is a good God that only good things are supposed to happen. But seasons include both good and bad times. Seasons include both good and bad times. Check out Ecclesiastes chapter 3, verses 2 through 8. Verses 2 through 8. And so the text, you know, it simply lays out that there is a time to be born and also a time to die, a time to plant and a time to harvest, a time to kill and a time to heal, a time to tear down and a time to build up, a time to cry and also a time to laugh, a time to dance and a time to grieve, a time to scatter stones and a time to gather stones, a time to embrace or to hug and a time to turn away, a time to search and a time to quit searching, a time to keep and also a time to throw away, a time to tear and a time to mend, a time to speak and a time to be quiet, a time to love and a time to hate, and a time for war and a time for peace. But beloved, regardless of the seasons in life, we can live purposeful and productive lives. And what this looks like, it is going to vary. It's going to look and feel different depending upon the season. But in each season, there are some things that can help you and I, that can help us to maximize the seasons, to maximize the moments. And so, you know, here's what they mean. How can we maximize the season? How can we maximize the season that we're in? And I got just a few points, and then I'm going to get out of your way. One is this: learn some things in this season. Learn some things in this season. Deuteronomy chapter 11, verse 2 says, "Remember what you have learned about the Lord through your experiences with Him." Your experiences with Him. It's important that we learn. When we truly learn, we grow. When we truly learn, we mature. When we truly learn, we gain wisdom. And we have various experiences and not the same experience over and over again, because if we don't get the lesson, we're going to have to take the lesson again. If we don't pass the test, and then we're going to have to be tried and tested again until we pass the test. If we were in person, I tell your neighbor, you need to get the lesson. You need to get the lesson. What can I learn in this season? Learn some things. We can learn some things in whatever season that we are in, and then we can come out better on the other side of the season. 2 Corinthians chapter 1, verse 9 says, "This happened, why? So that we might learn to trust not in ourselves, but God." Not in ourselves, but God. We might learn to trust not in ourselves, but God. So one of the big ideas that God wants you to learn is not to trust in yourself, but in God. Not to trust in yourself, but in God. This is extremely important, and this is something that it takes some of us a long time to get figured out. Because when we're leaning on anything other than God, we're leaning, the old folk would say, a broken stick. And so we should lean not to our own understanding, but in all of our ways, we acknowledge God, and God will direct our path. And so we don't trust in ourselves, but we trust in God. And I like to say this. When we talk about trusting in God, it's important that we believe in God and that we live in God, because it's in God that we live and move and we have our being. But it's important that we put our trust, that we entrust our lives to God, and that we receive and embrace God's love, God's great salvation for us. Okay. And so in each season, there are some things that can help us to maximize the moments, maximize the seasons by learning some things in the season. And then also, second thing, guess what? Even if the season is a tough season, it's a bad season, you can still find joy in this season. So that's the second point right there. Find joy in the season. Find joy in the season. Find joy in this season. Whatever season that you're in, you can find some joy in the season. And people ought to enjoy every day of their lives. Ecclesiastes chapter 11, verse 8. People ought to enjoy every day of their lives. Give thanks in all circumstances. This is the will of God for you. Give thanks in all. Listen, we're not thankful for everything, but we give thanks in all things. And so regardless of the season in which we find ourselves, beloved, we can learn some things in this season, and we can find joy in this season. Yeah, Paul, he said, I've learned to be content whatever the circumstance. And so then the third thing, guess what? If we're going to maximize the season, not only do we need to learn some things in this season and find joy in this season, but focus on what is priority in this season as opposed to that season. Focus on what is priority in this season. Ephesians chapter 5, verse 15 and 16 says, live life then with a due sense of responsibility, not as those who do not know the meaning and purpose of life. Do you know the meaning and the purpose of life, beloved? But as those who do, make the best use of your time. Despite all the difficulties these days, we are in some difficult days. But beloved, guess what? We can maximize this season by focusing on what is priority as opposed to what's not priority. Now, James chapter 4, and particularly verse 14, you know, James, he says this. He says, how do you know what your life will be like tomorrow? Your life is like a morning fog. It's here a little while, then it's gone. I want to back up. He says, look, you who say today or tomorrow, we're going to go to a certain town and we'll stay there a year. Will you do business there? We'll do business there and make a profit. And so he says, now, how do you know if you're going to be able to do any of this? Because your life is like a morning fog. It's here a little while, then it's gone. What you ought to say is, if the Lord wants us to, we will live and do this or that. Otherwise, you're boasting about your own pretentious plans. In other words, beloved, guess what? Focus on what is priority in this season, because guess what? Tomorrow, it is not promised. Next year is not promised. We're not promised a repeat of certain seasons in life. For example, beloved, watch this. You only get one chance to raise your children. Huh. Yes, you only get one chance to be a child. Yeah. And so there are certain seasons that come and they go. And when they go, they are gone. Let me say that again. There are certain seasons, they come and they go. And when they go, they are gone and they don't come back again. And so, beloved, what we want to focus on what is priority. For some, guess what? It's obeying your parents. It's obeying your parents right now, because they are your parents, one. And so we're called by God to honor our parents. And so you obey your parents, because at some point, if the Lord blesses you, you're going to be, you're going to get old enough and you're going to move out the house, and there are decisions that you're going to have to make on your own. And so you obey your parents and learn from your parents while you can. Education. Get your education. Get your education. graduate from high school and then go on to college and study. Parenting, it comes and it goes, or it's different seasons of parenting and what that may look like. But you want to make the most of it because we are not promised tomorrow and we don't get a do-over. Friendship and dating for marriage. These are things that may be a priority that we need to focus on in this season, that you need to focus on in this season. Laying the foundation for a solid marriage. These are seasons that come and they go that we don't want to miss, that we don't want to mess up. There are limitations, though, in every season. There are limitations and there are blessings that are particular to certain seasons. And if you miss the season and you don't maximize the season, you might miss the blessing. And so we need to live this season rather than that season. This season rather than that season. That season is gone. And so now live this season, the season that you're in. Be fully present in the season that you are in. And this will help you and I to find joy in this season. This will help us to give needed attention to what should be priority when we live this season rather than another season. And then the last thing is this, beloved. Do good in this season. Do good in this season. Do good in this season. Yes, as believers, as Christian, it doesn't matter what season you find yourself in, but it's always the season to do good. It's always a season to be a blessing. It's always in season. Yeah, to help somebody else. Whenever you're able to do good to people who need help, yeah, do it. Yeah, this is what Proverbs 3:27 says. Whenever you're able to do good to people who need help, whenever you're able, do good to people who need help. Do not withhold good from those who deserve it when it's in your power to help them. Yeah. Because guess what? If you wait for perfect conditions, you're never going to get anything done. We're always going to put it off, but it's always in season and appropriate to love. It's always in season and appropriate to do good in whatever season you find yourselves. And some of you may be a bit concerned because when you do good, you wondering, well, what about God's blessings toward me and when I extend myself? But beloved, listen here. Don't be weary in well-doing. We do good, guess what? Because it's good to do good, because God is good and God has been good and always will be good to us. God blesses us to be a blessing. And so as it has been given to us, we also give. And so guess what the text tells us in Genesis 8:22, as long as the earth endures, seed time and harvest, that is not going to cease. Seed time and harvest is not going to cease. What are you saying? In other words, you will reap in another season what you plant in one season. You will reap a harvest in another season, the seed that you plant in one season. Yeah. So don't be weary in well-doing, for in due season you're going to reap if we faint not. Yeah, what? And so what I'm going to reap in another season, what I plant in one season. Different seasons, but the same God. Maximize the seasons, beloved. Maximize the season. How do we maximize the season? How do we maximize the season? Yes. Learn some things in this season. Find joy in this season. Focus on what is priority in this season and do good in this season. Hallelujah. Thank you for joining with us. Pray that this word has been a blessing to help you in whatever season that you find yourselves. Although it's a different season, it's the same God. Let's go to the Lord in prayer. Lord God, we love you and we thank you, Lord God, for your faithfulness, Lord God. Lord God, and while our lives are full of different seasons, Lord God, we know that you are the same. You're the same yesterday, today, and forevermore, oh God. Lord, and so we look to you. We look to you, oh God. Thank you, Lord God. Help us, Lord God, to maximize the seasons, Lord God. Lord, we know that we can't control the seasons, oh God. Lord, but you are sovereign, oh God. Thank you, God. Lord, that you have a plan for us in every season, oh God. Thank you. Have your way, Lord God, in our lives. Help us, Lord God, to trust in you. Lord, because you are at work, God, in every season, God. Lord God, we pray that we will learn some things. Lord, we pray that we would find joy, Lord God, in the seasons. Thank you, God. Lord, and that we not be weary in well-doing, oh God. Thank you. For in due season, we will reap a harvest. Hallelujah. Because of the seeds that have been planted. We love you. These and other blessings we ask and give thanks. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. Amen. Beloved, we love you. Thank you for joining with us. Hope to see you next time.
Be blessed. Be encouraged.
Thank you for joining us today. You can connect in the following ways. Our Sunday morning worship at 11 a.m. via Facebook at Mount Olive, Waterbury, Connecticut, or our YouTube channel, Mount Olive AME Zion Church, or our website, MountOliveAMEZ.org, or you can simply use the dial-in number 339-207-6251. If you desire to make a donation, simply go to our website, or you can download the Giveify app and search for Mount Olive AME Zion Church. Again, thank you for tuning in. Hope we connect again.